Hi Scorpio, I'm Anisha. You can visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com to know more about my work. For those of you who are seeking a detailed analysis as to how the planets are going to be affecting you directly in your own specific charts, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com for a detailed personal consultation. From this month, I'm going to be adding a small tarot snippet. You can find that towards the end of the video, and in this I'm going to be giving you a gist from the tarot's perspective as to how it is that the month is looking for you. I'm going to be doing this for all the zodiacs. Do watch out for it, and I would love to get your feedback as to what you thought about it. So Scorpios, we begin the month with Mars that is going to be joining Saturn, and this is happening in a part of your chart which speaks about money. And during this time you seem to be driven to have more security in your life. You want to be financially sound and work harder at making more money. Some of you may take another job. Some of you can be in a space where you're pursuing money quite actively. There could be also a time wherein that you could be collaborating with some more people to be forming either not just a company but also another source of revenue that can come for you. It's also a good time to be evaluating your values and make sure that they fit in with your life right now, because this house is also about your own self-worth besides some money that is there. This is also a time where you're going to be wanting more stability for you in your personal life, and you are going to be taking any risks. So because it has to do with your earned income, because it has to do with your self-worth, ensure that you do not incur a huge cost in order to be having that sense of self-worth, or just in order to be having that assurance you need to be. Say for example, it can be as frivolous as just taking a trip which really exceeds your budget, but just because you will feel around this time that you can afford it, so you will just be spending a lot of money. We have Mercury that is aspecting, it's going to be transiting a part of your chart that speaks about love, romance and children, and this is quite lit up for you, and you're going to be feeling quite creative than usual. It can be an excellent work on creative projects during this time, but you could have some amount of a tough time trying to focus on one particular thing, Scorpios. It's also a time wherein that you could feel yourself being quite scatterbrained, or you could find that there are too many multiple things that are happening for you right now. You may also strongly defend your beliefs during this time, and you, because Mercury is there and it's highlighting, it's, you can expect a lot of conversations, you can expect a lot of great sense of humor, and because it has to do all with love, romance and children. You can also expect during this time that it's a time where you could be spending some amount of time with your children as well. In fact, for those of you who have been meaning to have a good talk with your children, this seems to be a great time during the Mercury transit that you could have that really important chat, or do a one-on-one thing with your, understanding more their thoughts and their feelings together. During this time also you could pick up a new hobby, or it could be an expensive or even a luxurious one for yourself, and you could be feeling in a space where you just want to pamper yourself, Scorpios. We have a new moon solar eclipse on the 9th, and this is again happening in a part of your chart that speaks about love, romance and children. So this is a time wherein you could be it speaks about new romance, Scorpios, and for those of you who have recently got into a relationship since about a year, it speaks about the relationship getting more deeper, maybe some wedding bells. For some of you, it also speaks about getting into a space where you could be socializing quite a bit, you could be spending some amount of money and looking good and buying newer stuff. It's also a time wherein that you could be feeling that you need to be having more fun in life, and you have the resources to be doing that, Scorpios. And if you have your eye on someone, it's a good time to be asking them out, because especially for romance, it's a great time wherein that you could find your potential mate. And like I said, for those of you, the relationship is it's fairly new, you could find it getting into a slightly more serious or more deeper note. You could be wanting as well to be more carefree. There just seems to be a lot of fun, seems to be a lot of happiness, a lot of creativity, you generally wanting to experiment a lot. Around the 13th of March, we have Venus that is moving into the house of day-to-day chores and health. And around this time, Venus being in your 6th house, you're not going to be easily falling in for someone's copiers. You're going to be with people whom you really know well, and you're going to be quite on an investigative mode. You're going to be digging more deeper and knowing as to what agenda do people have for you. And it is also be that you could also almost be interviewing people when you meet them. You know, you could be just assessing, doing a pro and a con analysis as to how it is that the person fits in your life and how it is that person works for you. And you could be meeting someone at your work as well. Quite a strong likelihood, Scorpius, for you to be meeting someone through your workspace, or even maybe someone whom you work with. You know, may not necessarily be that the person is from a larger, similar industry. It can also be, however, keeping that in mind, if it's a co-worker, try and ensure that it doesn't get too messy and it doesn't get too complicated, as normally office romances are best avoided. Around the 21st March, we have Sun that is moving into your same house of day-to-day chores and health. And Sun, of course, is making you going to focus on work. And it's not the time for play and silliness, Scorpios, and you're going to be getting through work projects more easily because you're going to be more focused and you're going to be paying attention to the detail. It's also an excellent time for getting smaller projects, to be focusing or finishing off smaller projects, but not really the larger ones, because you could have a sort of a hard time dealing with the larger picture during this time. You are going to be in a place where you are going to be dealing with your day-to-day affairs, the mundane tasks, you know, everything which you may be finding boring. But during this time, you may just find that you're quite able to deal with those better. And it's also a time when in Scorpius, you'll find that you are more comfortable, working by yourself rather than sort of starting things up on your own. And you could come across as someone who's quite with it, is in control and is analytic. Around the 23rd, we have Mercury that is going to be moving again into your house of day-to-day chores and health. And this house is really lit up for you, Scorpius. And Mercury being out here, it's going to help you focus more on your work. And it's a time wherein that, especially if you're a writer or you have to do anything with technology, or if you're working with the content, it's a brilliant time because you will be able to write more freely, you'll find the right words, and you'll be more articulate than usual. You may also have some conversations with your co-workers about your work, and it can also be during this time that your work environment could be far more busy than usual. Even where, as far as your health is concerned, it's a time wherein that you could be either experimenting with a new diet, or you could also be looking at ways to get more fitter. Some of you could just hire a personal trainer. Some of you could, you know, just look at fitness with new eyes. You know, you could just make a drastic change to your diet as to how it is that you eat food and how it is that you lead your life. Around the 23rd itself, we have a lunar eclipse. We have a full moon lunar eclipse, and this is happening in a part of your chart which has to do with behind the scenes. And this is entirely Scorpio's. Now, though eclipses normally, the effect lasts for about 6 months, and full moon, because it's far more emotional than the new moon, it speaks about some kind of a closure that is there, and you will be forced to sort of be dealing with subconscious problems. And it's a great time for therapy, and you could be tempted to sort of suppress your emotions, and this could lead to more problems or even a breakdown. And it can be that things that you have kept sort of hidden away, you have not shared, and they could just sort of bubble up and come to the surface. And allowing yourself to get in touch with your internal issues can be good during this time. And you may find that you're better able to deal with them and heal. Being alone is the best time for you during this time. It's a good time for reflecting. It's a good time for digging deep. It's a good time to be recharging the batteries of your soul, Scorpios. So ensure that you're not sort of really there in the spotlight, that you're staying away from too much of social activity. Ensure that you're not really caught up in the busyness of the life, and that you are you know, you're spending enough time with yourself. If you have the time and the resources, you should maybe take away to a resort and meditation camp. It's a brilliant time to be doing that. Try and get plenty of sleep during this time as well. And however, don't try to, some of you may get some, you know, vivid dreams around this time. So don't try and confuse the dream and the reality, and don't get too delusional around this time. And try not to have unrealistic expectations also out of yourself or from other people during this time as well. Scorpio is a tarot card for you. This month is a card of world, which is all about completion. It's about integration, accomplishment and travel. All your efforts that are there that you've put in right now, they're going to be finally paying off, and you have reached the end of a journey, or you have completed a major life cycle. You have endured hardships and challenges along the way, but these have only made you stronger and significantly wiser and more experienced than when you first started on your journey. A long-term project, period of study, relationship or career has finally come full circle, and you are now feeling a sense of closure as well as achievement and accomplishment. Scorpios, it's a lovely month for you. I think for a lot of you are finally, besides of course a lot of retail therapy that seems to be happening, some amount of new love as well. I think there is a sense of achievement that is there in this entire month, that you finally managed to be in the space where you wanted to be when you started out. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Scorpios. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.